plan is on track. I'll bring Maxine to the prison today, and you can say your piece. Until we execute the plan, this is our secret. No one can know we're working together.
You're working for Eric. Right.
Basie, you got this wrong. I wouldn't help a toad like Eric Foster if my life depended on it.
Now, I'm not stupid. I heard you on the phone to the prison yesterday.
Look, Lacey.
Why would you want to represent that creep?
Because he's blackmailing me.
How?
Eric is desperate to get his sentence reduced. And he thinks convincing Maxine that he's a reformed character is going to help his cause.
But he's not reformed. What if he's blackmailing you?
Clearly. But if I don't get Maxine to that meeting, he's going to have me sent down.
Right. So you're willing to deceive your colleague, your friend, in order to save your own skin?
In a word, yes.
No, you're not.
But what are you doing?
Tell Maxine the Eric meeting's off. Or I will.
It's off. I'm building myself up for this meeting all weekend. Well, now you tell me that Eric doesn't want to see me.
Hey, Max, look, I know you're disappointed, but you've already beaten Eric. Come on, you won. Isn't it about time you moved on with your life?
Email from the prison. Apparently the meeting's back on.
James, that's our taxi. What am I doing?
You go to the cab, I'll be right there. I just need to catch Lacey up on a case.
Fine.
What do you think you're doing?
If you want to be a lawyer, sometimes you need to make morally ambiguous decisions. You turn a blind eye to things you might not agree with.
I don't care. I can't let you do this.
I am taking Maxine to visit Eric, and you cannot stop me. Or I will terminate your contract with immediate effect, and I'll let every law firm in the country know you're a disrespectful, insufferable, unhireable wannabe. Is that understood?
As long as we practice. Oh, don't tell me you've hit an iceberg.
I'm having a nightmare.
Why? What's happened?
Leaky pipe. Meant to have looked at it ages ago.
Oh, don't worry about it, mate. That comes with old age.
Yeah. Well, nice one for coming at short notice. With all these Eurovision fans milling around, I need to reopen immediatamente.
No problemo, Damo.
Yeah, but listen, next time, come to us direct, yeah? Because this just encourages rival companies.
Well, I'm hoping there won't be a next time.
Damon, saw your ad requesting the services of a cleaning goddess.
But hang on a minute, I thought you was running the loft with Ethan.
Well, yeah, I am, but I still need an extra income. And hey, seeing as we're all here, why don't we just get the Daddy Sheen team back together?
Absolutely, get it, Mia.
Yay!
Woo!
Happy birthday.
What? Great.
Thanks,
partner.
Me, but I can't let you do this to Maxine.
What?
He's representing Eric.
I mean, the flat's been fine, but the twins are getting older and they're still sharing a room. Maybe that's part of the reason that Sebastian's been acting up.
You don't know that.
I just feel like I'm failing my kids. I owe it to them to give them a proper house and all the things that I never had growing up, which is why I found this place on the outside of town.
Oh, wow, Sienna, that is amazing.
I know.
So when are you moving in?
Well, that's the thing. We're not. I mean, we're so far off the deposit we would need for this, and all of the income from the loft is tied up in bills, which is why I really need my old job back.
Yeah, no props.
Oh, we'll talk about it later, yeah? Oh, tea break.
Right. Nice one.
Is she okay?
Hey.
Well, she just seemed very resistant to the idea of us working together again.
I've took James's lunch by accident. Right, I'll be back in a minute. I hate prawns.
Stay.
When I walked in before, this is what you were talking about, wasn't it? You lied and said that Eric cancelled that meeting because you were trying to talk yourself out of trouble.
Maxine, I'm sorry.
All this time you have been bigging me up, convincing me to go and see Eric, and none of this was for me.
I was just doing what my client had told me to do.
Client? James, I am not just your colleague, I am your friend. How could you do this to me?
I was going to tell you.
That is a lie. If Lacey hadn't have intervened, you'd have taken me to see him. You'd have led me straight into his trap, you bitch!
You forgot your lunch. What's going on?
Maxine knows about Eric.
You knew?
Je vous...
Max. I swear on Leah and Lucas's lives, James wanted to come clean about Eric. It was me. I made him go through with it.
I don't believe anything you two say anymore.
It's the truth.
Why?
Why would you let him betray me? Why would you let him side with that monster instead of me?
For Juliet. You know, if anything happened to her, I couldn't bear the thought of him being stuck behind bars.
The money Eric gave me was going to pay for Juliet's private cancer treatment. I know it's not a good excuse, but I was desperate.
We are still desperate. Maxine, I'm sorry to put you in this position, but if James does not get you to that prison, then Eric will come good on his threat, and then it's my fiancé that's stuck in jail.
After everything he did to me, you expect me to give him what he wants? Be a pawn in this dirty game?
I know it's not an easy thing to do.
Eric tried to kill me, Steve. He terrorised this community. I'm not doing anything for him.
Then do it for Juliet. She needs me now more than ever. I can't go to prison. Please, Maxine, I'm begging you, let me help my sister.
Do you know, I wish I could say I was shocked, but there's honestly nothing that serpent James Nightingale could do that would surprise me anymore. Still, look on the bright side, eh? Now you get to spend the next 24 hours watching Harry and Meghan with Auntie Scott. Oh. Right.
Who are we talking to?
Steve!
No, I'm cooking for James. He's had a nightmare day.
Oh, well, he's not the only one. But why would you bail and leave me cleaning the boat with Sienna?
I know she rocked up out of the blue, but I've had a text message off Damon. He's really happy with the job you did.
Do you think I'm bothered about what Damon said? No, I'm bothered about our finances. See, we're really struggling. Look, we can't offer Sienna any more shifts with us.
She's been with me from the start. She's my wingwoman, my partner in crime.
And look what happened the last time you two worked together.
She's turned over a new leaf.
Oh.
No, she has. She's trying to make a new life for her and kids.
Stay. We're in a cost of living crisis. This is going to put you in a tricky situation with Sienna, but we just can't do it.
Oh, you really think I can say to Sienna, sorry, you're fired?
Do you want your business to survive? Then yeah.
Leela.
Ah, yes, hello. I need to speak with my client, Eric Foster. I have some news. Hold, please.
I will go and talk to Eric tomorrow. But if I find out you've told any more lies, I promise you, your life won't be worth living.